Ladies and gentlemen, the rising popularity and the demand of virtual reality, customers and users claim for some use cases. And ladies and gentlemen, there's a company you have to know. Actually, that company combined two of the last hottest topics, virtual reality and drones. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a gentleman who did it all. Please fasten your seatbelts, ladies and gentlemen, for Nicolas Chibac, the co-founder of Spherie.
Hi, how are you?
It's all yours.
Woo! Yeah, wow. I'm really happy, and I have to say pretty excited to be here on stage today. 6 months ago, I got a call from Nicolas. I'm called Nicolas, pretty close. And Nicolas from Mexico asked me, do you want to be on stage? What are you doing? How is your drone doing at the moment? And I said, oh, it's great. We have been to Necker Island, Facebook, around the world. The Hala became investor. And yeah, check out our trailer for this. So he watched the trailer. And then he asked me, yeah, do you want to be on stage again? What is your actual steps at the moment? I said, it's exciting. We're just in the development of Spherie 2.0, the evolutionary next step. And so I said, yeah, why not? What is the date? And then he told me the date, and I thought, ooh, that's 2 months earlier than we expected to finish a drone. And who knows maybe how it is to build a hardware and software product? It's hard, actually. And to finish a product earlier than the original timeline is even harder. So I said, I'm not so sure. And he said, don't worry. If you're not finished, it's okay, but you should better finish. Yeah. So I said, okay, why not? We do it. We will be on stage. And I thought, yeah, anyway, I mean, it's always good to have time pressure and a hard deadline. Otherwise, you will never finish your product. So here I am. And 6 months flew by really quickly, I have to say. When you think in that moment, oh, 6 months, until then I can turn the world around, but the world is still in position, and we had not that much time to finish it. But I can say today is really the world premiere of our new drone. You will see it for the first time. But to torture you a little bit longer, I would like to tell you first what's our passion, why we do all this, what drives us every day. To develop a drone today. And so we believe there will be a digital twin for nearly everything, for real estate, for industrial facilities, for people, so all human beings, actually for the whole world. So we believe there will be a digital twin of nearly everything. So, and to create this, you need a tool, something how to capture all these environments. And we believe that the drone is a perfect tool for this. So that brought us to the situation to develop a drone. Actually, I have more the virtual reality background original and the film background, but then we merged technologies and yeah, we developed Spherie 1.0, and now today we will show Spherie 2.0. But actually, I don't see anything here on the screen. So okay, black as well. No, but that's right, because I think it's black in between. So we thought, if we create a digital twin, or what is really the reason for a digital twin? I mean, it's the two worlds will really merge together, the digital world and the real world. It's happening already here all over. Yeah? We all have a smartphone in the hand, but this will get much deeper impact our life every day, because we believe in the near future, the virtual and the real world will merge that close together that we cannot even see the differences anymore. So that it will be hard for us to see what is the real world and what's the virtual world. This sounds scary for me as well, but it will happen because it will be technological-wise possible. Not yet, but it will come. And if it comes, it will be like a tsunami. Yeah? You say maybe our virtual reality went already over its high point. It's not that exciting. It's not impacting the market that fast like expected, but it's a slowly growing big wave. Yeah, and if it comes to hit the coastline of reality, it will be a tsunami and will really impact us deeply. So we really have to think early about this, and that's why we founded the virtual reality headquarters in Hamburg. It's a 2,000 square meter space in the city center where we have innovation space, experience space, production space, where politicians, scientists, the industry, the public, everybody comes together and we can talk about these, all these ethical questions which we are facing in this new digital world. So one of the big players in this capturing of the real world, because you need first to capture the real world into the digital world to make it alive or to work with it, this is stuff we do, but actually the bigger player in this game is Google, for example. I mean, you all use it every day, Google Maps, Android, Google Earth, and this is actually a digital twin of the world, what Google does there. So it enhances this with real data in real time, so you use it for everyday traveling from A to B to use all the different functionalities. So it's really a living digital twin, what you use every day. And here you see one example of how we use our technology to make it virtual, in virtual reality possible to experience. So here you have a flying drone where you can sit inside and you move inside of the cabin and you see the real environment around you. So it's not just a 360 film where you just can look around, you can really move into it. So it's kind of next step. I think in the next podium discussion we have also volumetric capturing, volumetric VR. So this is kind of the next step after 360 video. In our vision, our drone will be the size of an orange, flying through an environment, capturing the space autonomously without the help of a pilot, just flies through a complicated space like a building or this environment and generates in real time a 3D copy, which you then can later use for any kind of enhancements. Actually, we are not the first ones who thought about this, and the filmmakers, the visionaries are always a little bit ahead. So maybe you saw this movie, Alien Prometheus. There they used already drones to fly through an alien ship to create a digital twin of the alien ship and then to present it in a hologram on screen. So I have to say, we are not there yet, but what we are working on, and Spherie 2.0 is one big evolutionary step into this direction. So I'm really happy to present you today Spherie 2.0. Wow, thank you, Eric and Mo. I have to say, it's not the first time we were flying it, but we just finished in time, I have to say. So, I'm lucky nobody got hurt. No, don't worry. We were really safe to showcase it today. It was still a little bit loud, as you could hear. This is really the first prototype. Actually, I didn't think about showing it on stage. This is already the update, which has different propellers, it's much lighter, less loud, and even more capable of the functionalities. So what is so unique about this drone? Maybe you know some drones, maybe some of you use a DJI Mavic or so. This drone looks completely different, if you can see. It has 6 cameras inside. Let me show you. So it has 6 cameras inside, it has 9 leaders, for positioning itself in the space and measuring the environment. It has 8 rotors. It has a lot of power. Actually, it comes with 11 kilowatt, what is about 15 horsepowers in such a small drone. So it can fly up to 100, with a top speed of up to 150 kilometers per hour. It carrying six cameras, right? Normal drone has one camera. This has six cameras. And then it does a lot of stuff, actually. We had to invent a lot of new stuff to fulfill all our needs. And had to invent new things never been on the market before. We have, for example, a special heat system, which is 3D printed. So it's 3D printed metal, which guides the temperature from inside to outside and is in the airflow of the rotors. Yeah, what else? There's a lot of stuff. There's a UFO mode, which lets the drone fly like an UFO. Maybe you know a normal drone flies and navigates by tilting. So this drone, because the rotors are tilted and we have a specific flight mode, we call it UFO mode, the drone can fly like this. So it doesn't have to tilt like any other drone. You'd see drones normally do all the time things like this, and they have a gimbal below to stabilize the camera, but we have the six cameras all inside, so they the drone itself has to be super stable. So the drone can fly like an UFO. And I mean, the really unique thing is, like you can see, there are six cameras here, and they're all facing in all directions, so you have a full spherical view, and in the image, you don't see the drone itself. So the cameras facing to the edge of the rotors and closing from here, full spherical image. So you have the top, you have the bottom, you have everything. We call it actually the God view, because there's nothing else in the world that can make a full 360 video without something in the picture. There are workarounds, and you can do it in a post, but this one does it really directly. So it's pretty cool. Yeah, this goes to the team. Actually, Eric, the chief engineer, he was flying the drone, and Mo also, he was building mainly the 3D model. They had a hard time. I feel a little bit like in Star Trek when Scotty crashed the Enterprise and Kirk calls him, how fast can we bring it to life again? And he says, yeah, wow, everything is damaged, 6 hours. And Kirk just says, you have 1 hour, let's do it. We had a lot of conversations like this to bring it to stage today. So, but the drone, I have to say, and now the engineers have to listen away, is just fulfilling a functionality. Yeah, it's the drone we just used to fly the sensors around in the space. What you saw here before is like the normal view of a drone or any camera, but with a 360 view, we can see really everything. Here, for example, flying into the private space of Richard Branson on Necker Island. Or here flying in the Mercedes-Benz Museum. Unfortunately, this is still filmed with Spherie 1.0. This drone is so new, we weren't even able to capture the content with a new version before the stage time today. So we also got a really exciting investor, the Hala. Maybe somebody here from Hamburg. One? There are more, I know. So Hala is mainly owning the harbor of Hamburg. It's also really city-owned, has a lot of terminals. And yeah, the Hala became an investor, and we are also now involved in a lot of infrastructure projects to create 3D models and digital twins of city parts. And let's show you one currently running project, for example. There's an old train station in Hamburg. It was the old connection from Hamburg to Hannover. So we went with a drone through the environment and took a 3D scan of the environment, including the textures. So it's not just a LiDAR scan, it's also the textures of it. And then used this model, put it into the VR world, and then what everybody else, the big players, always show in nice image videos, we do already in real. We went there with the investors and partners, and showcased in the real space, the virtual version of it, in new forms. I mean, this will be a vibrant new space, and they think about new ideas, how they want to bring it to life. There will be a garden inside, or a jungle kind, or a cafe, so there are possibilities, and we showcase that in VR. Using the drone to capture the reality, and then enhance it, and bring the people in virtual reality into the space, and really see different possibilities. Another really nice use case is we're creating now content of the most exciting areas in the world, or some of them, and create sky rides. What we saw already before, that we have a real cabin, and we put the people inside together. For example, here, six people at the same time, and they can fly above cities. and experience like a city tour of the city, just virtual, but from a completely new perspective. So it's interesting for people who have never been there before or already lived for a long time in the city but never saw it from the air. So it's similar to a bus tour, which takes 2 hours, goes through the traffic, is weather depending. This one is always in nice weather conditions, yeah? We have always the best situation, and you get a nice overview in 10 minutes, fly above the city, and then you can choose afterwards where you want to go. Obviously, there are much more possibilities to go on from here as well. So, and I can say, maybe I'm allowed to say, Lucas, for example, this drone is so new, but next week, I see Lucas here, we're going to use it for a classic car race in the Swiss mountains to make an immersive experience of this car race in the mountains. So I'm super excited, just on stage next week already in action, creating new content. So there are many projects like this, because you can also imagine if we do an infrastructure and we have this 360 view, it is also a really nice tool for emergency response situations, yeah, like or helpful for fire workers or whoever, because this drone can go inside of an environment, nobody else can go inside and sees everything. I mean, it can see better than me. I can just turn around and I don't see what's behind me. This drone can see everything at the same time. So it's really, yeah, we don't even know what we can all do with this thing, but we have it here. So maybe you have some ideas what you want to do with it. What brings me to the next step? We have still 2 minutes, I see, for questions or any ideas. Maybe we want to bring that already to the next level. Thank you. Actually, this was tough for me. 6 months to here. Yeah, we are really happy that the drone was flying. I mean, not today. I was super sure that nothing gonna happen, but it was like, do we really finish the product in time? I don't know. Is anybody here in the hardware production?
Nobody.
Yeah, it's all software, but it's tough. It's fucking tough. There's so many problems coming up when you're in the progress. Thanks for my engineering team as well. Thanks again.